Hi everybody. Welcome to Let's Study Cancer Channel, LFC. Thank you so much for your support. Today I want us to look at one of the most common cancers, not only in the United States, but in the world right now, that affects men exclusively, that is referred to as prostate cancer. Now there's so many interesting things that we're going to look at today, but briefly just want to have some introduction about the prostate cancer and a few things about it that will help us to have a clear understanding about the disease. Now before we start, I just want to ask you, if you've not yet subscribed to Let's Study Cancer channel, kindly I want to ask you to take a second or two to do so. There's a notification button below, subscription button. Just click on it. That way you'll be become a member of the Let's Study Cancer LHC family, and we'll be glad to have you on board. Once again, thank you so much for your support. We need it, and we're hoping to get far. Now, at the same time, while you're at it, I want to ask you to humbly give us a thumbs up. If you like what you're doing, if you like what you started, just give us a thumbs up and like our videos. And also, be careful to drop a comment below. We'd love to know how we are doing. If you have any opinions, if you've got any suggestions, I mean, this is science and it's a broad subject of research and study. Once again, as I told you in the past, I'm a PhD student, studying PhD in community health and development, and my research is based on cancer. And over time in my practice, we've come to develop a special liking in the field of cancer. And in my research, I just found out there's so many people out there that basically have no idea at all, or they just know they've had once or twice about cancer, but they don't know, you know, the nitty-gritties that are very important that could help us save a life somewhere. And so that's where this channel was born, to just openly share one-on-one on the basics of cancer, the various types of cancer. And we're hoping to take it further from there. And so today we'll be looking at prostate cancer, and this is a very, very interesting type of cancer. A few days ago, when I was being a part of my research, I met a woman that was as brutal, honest as possible, you know, as honest as it can come, as it comes. And she was asking me, my father was diagnosed with prostate cancer, my brother too. And I'm just wondering whether I too might have the same. You know, such a young girl. And I didn't know whether to laugh, because again, prostate cancer only affects men exclusively. And the reason is simple, because it is a cancer that affects the prostate gland. And the prostate gland is found in men only. Women do not have the prostate gland. And so, yeah, having said that, now it's off my chest. Now let's dive into prostate cancer. Now, the prostate is a small walnut-shaped gland in the pelvis of men. As we have said, it's exclusively found in men. Now, it is located next to the bladder, and it can be examined by getting a digital rectal exam, the DRE exam. Now, I know these are very scary exams. Yeah, most men wouldn't want to have nothing to do with it. But when you do that exam, then it's very possible to get to feel it. You'll be able to palpate it and feel it, and to get to know the size, and you know whether it's a hypertrophy, whether it's increased in size or not. Now, the prostate cancer is a form of cancer that develops in the prostate gland, as we have mentioned, and it is the second leading cause of cancer death for men in the United States. And from the statistics, you find out that just about one in nine men, one in every nine men will be diagnosed with prostate cancer in their lifetime. Now, these numbers are shocking, And obviously they're from researches that have been done over time, and they've been proven, and these numbers are alarming. And this year alone in 2020, it was estimated that just somewhere about 191,000 men will be diagnosed with prostate cancer in the United States alone. Now these numbers are shocking. And then as you realize later on, as we will be studying and dissecting prostate cancer, that for some reason it's more common in African American men compared to the other races, and we'll get to understand why later as we go on. So growths in the prostate can either be benign, they can be non-cancerous, and at the same time these growths can also be cancerous or malignant in nature. Now, benign growths, the non-cancerous one, is always referred to as the BPH, benign prostatic hyperplasia. Now, some of the characteristics of the BPH is they are rarely a threat to life, they are rarely life-threatening, and they don't invade tissues around them. They are not invasive, they are not cancerous in nature, and they don't spread to other parts of the body as well. They'll never spread, they're just localized within the prostate. And the other thing is that they can be removed and can grow back very slowly, but usually they don't grow back. They can be surgically resected, they can be surgically removed, and you can get on along with life. Now, the malignant growths that are found in the prostate, or referred to as the prostate cancer, they may sometimes be life-threatening, not always, to some degree, and they can spread to nearby organs and tissues, such as the blood and the rectum, obviously, that the neighbors are the just closer to the prostate. So in some cases, we find that the cancer, the prostate cancer, will metastasize and spread to these nearby tissues and organs as well. Now, it can also spread to other parts of the body, like the lymph nodes and even the bone, or sometimes depending on the staging of the cancer, especially in the latter stages, this cancer is highly invasive and it can spread to other parts of the body. Often prostate cancer can be removed. It can be cured. It's very possible to cure prostate cancer 100%, but obviously it will depend on how soon it is diagnosed, it is detected. That is why it's very important, and we tend to encourage early cancer screening, early prostate cancer screening. That way the cancer will be detected early, before it progresses to the latter stages. And at that stage, at the early stages, it is very, very receptive to therapy and to cure, and it can be dealt with and be fixed at that time. Now, prostate cancer cells can spread by breaking away from a prostate tumor to other parts of the body. We've talked about the bones and the lymph nodes, and they can also travel through the blood vessels or the lymph nodes to reach other parts of the body. Now, after spreading, the cancer cells may attach to other tissues and grow to form new tumors that obviously will be damaging as well, based on where they will land, they will fall onto and develop. And remember this, as we mentioned in our very first video, even though prostate cancer might spread, or any other type of cancer might spread, and it attaches to some other organ, and it forms a cancer, it develops cancer. The name of that type of cancer, the name of that cancer after spreading, will not change to the new site. The name will still be the primary site, the original site where the cancer was initially. So even though the prostate cancer has spread to some other part of the body, for example, the bones, it will still be referred to as prostate cancer. It will never change the name. Now, when the prostate cancer spreads from its original place to another part of the body, now the new tumor will have the same kind of abnormal cells and the same name as the primary or the original tumor, as we had talked about. Now, for example, prostate cancer will get to spread to the bones, and the cancer cells in the bones are actually now referred to as prostate cancer cells or metastasized prostate cancer cells. The disease is metastatic prostate cancer, not bone cancer. I think I've already overemphasized on that. Now, basically, that's just an introduction on prostate cancer. Quickly, I want us to have just a summary on what we have covered on the introduction of prostate cancer. Now, we say prostate cancer is a cancer that occurs in the prostate gland exclusively, and the prostate is a small walnut-shaped gland that is found in the male, in the pelvis. And the function of the prostate gland is to produce what is referred to as the seminal fluid that actually nourishes, responsible for nourishing and transporting the sperm during intercourse. Now, the prostate cancer is one of the most common types of cancer, and many prostate cancers grow slowly and are confined to the prostate gland. Yeah. Now, where they may not cause serious harm, as I said in the past, a while ago, it is not all prostate cancer that will be life-threatening. Now, however, while some type of prostate cancer, they will still grow slowly and may need minimal or even no treatment. There are other types, however, that are very aggressive and will spread quickly. They are very, very aggressive and invasive. They will spread quickly within a short period of time, and they are very, very life-threatening. It's important to differentiate that. Now, prostate cancer that's detected early when it's still confined within the prostate gland, it has the best chance for successful treatment. Remember this. Cancer that is still confined within the prostate gland, the success rates and the survival rates, you know, and the prognosis with therapy, it's almost 100% guaranteed. The problem comes when it's in its latter stages and it has already spread to other parts of the body, and it's no longer confined, it's no longer localized within the prostate. Thank you so much for tuning in. That's just a brief introduction on prostate cancer. And if there's anything that you would love to know more about it, just shoot us a comment below. If there's anything you'd love to add, and let us know in the comment section below. We'll take a time to answer and to revert back to you. Now, again, I have two questions for you. Just wanted to know whether you've had a one-on-one contact with prostate cancer. I mean, do you know anyone in your family, anyone that is that close enough to you, could be a friend, it could be a relative, that has suffered or that has been diagnosed, or has been diagnosed in the past or even now with prostate cancer? And again, we'd love to get to know from you. What do you think? What are your comments about prostate cancer? Do you think it's really treatable? And what do you think about the available options, you know, treatment options that are available today? And we'll pick it up from there. I want to ask you, if you've not yet subscribed to this channel, to kindly take a second or two to subscribe to this channel as we get to grow together. And also, I want to ask you to hit the notification bell button below. That way, when you do that, every time Let Study Cancer get to upload a brand new video, YouTube will send you a notification, and that way you will have an opportunity to get to watch the video among the very first people. So once again, remember to give us a thumbs up. Remember to leave us a comment, and we'll be glad to receive your support, your honest support on what we're doing. And God bless you. See you in the next video.